This is Bartolomescu, and you're watching the channel of the Medical Futures. CSI and its endless spin-offs have enchanted millions of viewers with the hocus-pocus of technology as forensic medicine's ultimate toolkit for finding criminals fast and efficiently. Let's take a look at what the future of CSI might really look like. It's the year 2040, and a young woman was just murdered in a New York apartment. As the forensic team arrives, they start to investigate with their portable labs. They take pictures, DNA, and microbiome samples from the room and the body. What's a microbiome, you might ask? Humans emit tens of millions of bacteria every hour. That's the microbiome that we constantly add to our surroundings. And that means that we leave our traces in everything we touch, we sit on, or where we walk. And it's been proven that each individual's microbiome is unique, just like a fingerprint or DNA. After the body has been taken to the coroner's office, the forensic team scans the body inside out and creates a 3D model of her. While the victim's body gets taken to a local funeral home, the forensic team starts the virtual autopsy to establish the cause of death. They were able to collect DNA from the victim's body, and now they can use it for phenotyping, a method to determine what the perpetrator looks like. Even today, DNA phenotyping can predict the age and the gender of the given person, the hair and the eye color, the height and the race. By 2040, our forensic team is able to accurately reconstruct physical features from a small amount of DNA. Now that the police have a picture of a suspect, they can use artificial intelligence to catch him. Facial recognition algorithms are nothing new. Facebook uses it when suggesting whom to tag in photos. In a matter of hours, CCTV catches a glimpse of the guy and the police brings him in. By now, brain mapping and analysis of how a subject responds under EEG and functional magnetic resonance imaging replaced conventional polygraphs. So while the detectives put the suspect under a brain scan polygraph to question him, the forensic team applies a different approach. They take microbiome sample from the suspect and match it with the one they collected at the crime scene. In a day, detectives and the forensic team establish that they caught the perpetrator. After that, they reconstruct the whole crime scene in 3D, and with virtual reality headsets, they transport the entire grand jury there and play out what happened exactly. It's game over, we might think. But authorities raise the real question only now. How could a crime happen in the age of pre-crime policing? In the 21st century, the Scotland Yard applied a policing software known as PredPol to predict areas where crimes may take place to deploy more officers there. Since then, tools for pre-crime policing got even more sophisticated, just as the ones in Minority Report, where authorities are able to predict crimes and catch criminals before the actual crime takes place. So how could anything like a murder happen?